Antonio Project presents Inner Gas System Part 5 Types of Inner Gas System for Tankers.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Do you ever wonder why tankers don't explode despite carrying highly combustible materials? The secret lies in inner gas systems, which prevent fire by replacing hazardous atmosphere with non-reactive gases. But you know, not all inner gases are the same. In this video, we will break down the types of tankers and the main types of inner gases used on tankers, their pros and cons, and how they work. Whether you are a seafarer, an engineer, or just tech enthusiast, stick around because this is essential knowledge for anyone in the maritime world. Are you ready to explore? Let's get started.
Types of gas carriers. Tankers with 8,000 deadweight and over carrying low flashpoint cargoes and constructed or keeled on or after 1 January 2016 must be provided with a fixed inner gas system, complying with Chapter 15 of the amended FSS code. The following are several types of gas tankers that use inner gases for their operations. LNG or liquefied natural gas carriers to transport LNG or primarily methane with temperature is minus 162 degrees Celsius or minus 260 degrees Fahrenheit. FSRU or floating storage and regasification unit. FSRU used for storage LNG and convert LNG to gas or as regasification facility. LNG carrier and FSRU equipped with cryogenic containment systems like membrane, MOS, SPP, and so on. LEG, liquefied ethylene gas carrier, to transport liquefied ethylene with temperature minus 104 degrees Celsius. Methanol carrier and ethanol carrier, primarily transported as liquid. Cryogenic or pressurized tanks may be used for transportation. LPG or liquefied petroleum gas carrier to transport LPG, typically propane and butane, with temperature minus 50 degrees Celsius. LPG carrier can be fully pressurized or semi-pressurized type. For gas carriers, the type of inner gas used is dry inner gas. For details about gas carriers, please watch my video IMO classification of gas carrier. Types of oil and chemical tankers. Following is the types of oil and chemical tankers. Crude oil tankers to transport unrefined crude oil from oil fields to refineries. Very large crude carrier or VLCC with size 200,000 until 320,000 deadweight. Ultra large crude carrier or ULCC with size over than 320,000 deadweight. Product tankers to carry refined petroleum products, for example, gasoline, diesel, kerosene, jet fuel, including fuel bunkering vessel. Chemical tanker, type 1 chemical tanker, carries highly hazardous substances, for example, acids, toxic chemicals. Type 2 chemical tanker, for moderately hazardous cargo, such as solvents, alcohols, caustic soda, and so on. Type 3 chemical tanker, for cargoes of relatively low hazard, such as vegetable oils, molasses, less hazardous chemicals. For oil tankers, wet inner gas type used for their cargo operation. Nitrogen generators. Nitrogen or N2 is one of the types of dry inner gas used in gas tankers. For details about nitrogen, please watch my previous video with title, Is Nitrogen Really an Inner Gas? For gas carrier, nitrogen used for following purposes. 1. Purging of piping line. 2. Gas sealing for gas compressor. 3. Fire suppression for inerting. There are two types of endogenerator generator used on both of gas carrier. 1. Pressure swing absorption system. 2. Membrane system. In principle, nitrogen is produced by an N2 generator by separating gas from air in the separation module. Compressed air from feed air compressor fed to separation module. PSA system module use special absorbent beds, usually zeolite or carbon molecular sieves. Adsorbent preferentially adsorb oxygen and other gases, while allowing nitrogen to pass through. For membrane module, it use semi-permeable membrane to separate nitrogen from compressed air. For details on how the nitrogen generator works, I will explain in the future. Dry inert gas generator. Gas carrier operating at cryogenic temperatures. The use of dry type inert gas systems primarily for safety and cargo quality. Dry inert gas prevents ice formation and chemical degradation of the cargo. Meanwhile, wet inert gas, like flue gas from boilers, contain moisture, which can react with the cargo and freeze during loading or unloading of refrigerated cargoes. The other purpose is dry gas helps maintain the integrity of cargo systems. Moisture in inert gas can cause corrosion in pipelines and tanks. The working principle of dry inert gas generator is as follow. Air intake, ambient air is drawn in using a blower or compressor. The air is filtered to remove dust and particles. Combustion, a hydrocarbon fuel is mixed with air and burned in a combustion chamber. The combustion process is oxygen controlled, meaning only partial combustion occurs to reduce oxygen levels. Gas cooling, the hot combustion gases are cooled down using a scrubber. Water removal or drying, water vapor is removed by refrigeration and desiccant dryer. Details of working process of dry inert gas system will be explained in the next video. Flue gas inert gas system. Boiler flue gas inert gas system is a type of inert gas generation system commonly used on oil tankers, particularly crude oil carriers. It uses flue gases from a ship's boiler as a source of inert gas to prevent explosions by reducing the oxygen content in cargo tanks. Flue gas inert gas system produce wet inert gas. Flue gas from boilers by product of burned fuel, usually heavy fuel oil or marine diesel oil. The flue gas passes through a scrubber tower where it is cooled with seawater or fresh water, then washed to remove soot, sulfur, and acidic gases. Water is removed from the scrubbed gas using demisters or separators to produce a dry, clean inert gas. The IGS blower used to draw flue gas from boiler uptake and scrubber, then it is delivered to cargo tank, passing through deck seal water. Wet inert gas generator. Wet inert gas generator producing wet type inert gas. Generally, this type of wet IGG used on crude oil and product tankers. Following is working principle in brief for wet inert gas generator. The IGG blower or fan supplies air to the combustion chamber. Then diesel oil is mixed with the air. This mixture is burned in a controlled oxygen environment in the combustion chamber burner unit. Combustion chamber and scrubber is combined unit. The flue gas passes through a scrubber tower Using seawater and passing the mister, the flue gas from combustion chamber is cooled down and cleaned. This is to remove impurities such as sulfur oxide or SOx, particulate matter, and other contaminants from the inner gas to prevent corrosion, environmental pollution, or operational issues. Then, inner gas enter tank water seal before use for cargo tank, inner tank, or purging. Summary. There are several types of inner gas systems being used. It is depending on the cargo type, vessel design, and safety requirements. The following table shows a summary of the types of inner gas systems used on board tankers. Basically, inner gas divided into two types, wet type inner gas and dry type inner gas. Flue gas inner gas system and wet inner gas generator included to wet type due to producing moist or some water vapor remains on the inner gas. Meanwhile, nitrogen generator and dry inner gas generator included to dry inner gas. It produces dry inner gas. This is to prevent ice formation and chemical degradation of the cargo. As you can see from the shown table, it shows the differences between each type of inner gas system.
And that's wrap on inner gases for tankers. We have covered the key types from nitrogen to flue gas and how they work. Inner gas systems are truly the unsung heroes of maritime safety. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button. It really supports my channel. And if you haven't already, subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you never miss our next deep dive into marine engineering or shipping tech. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.
Got question or want to see a specific topic cover? Drop a comment below. We read them all. Thank you for watching, and until next time, stay safe and keep sailing smart. Let's spend our time to study and take any positive energy to improve our knowledge.
Thank you for watching my video. Terima kasih. The Antonio Project.